Hello, today I am going to discuss C language MCQ question answer. If you like my videos, then like, share and subscribe channel. This is my YouTube channel link. Now I describe some important C language questions. What will be the output of the following arithmetic expressions? Arithmetic expressions are given. We have to write these arithmetic expressions in this way. We calculate it first. 2 percentage 10, that is 2 percentage 10 means 2. Here percentage sign is used for calculating remainders. So 2 percentage 10 means 2. We write it here. Then we calculate 3 into 2 means 6. 8 into 6 means 48. And 5. We calculate it as -37. So answer becomes -37. Next question. What will be the output of the following statements? Here I write int x equal to 1, 2, 3, then print percentage d and percentage capital D, x3, x2, x1. We first write array 1, 2, 3 as 1, 2, 3, but location, fourth locations we cannot define, so we write it with cross sign. So the array index becomes 0, 1, 2, 3. So here x3 means 0 or any garbage value, that is this value, and x2 is 3, that is this value, and x1 is 2, that is this value. So answer becomes 0, 3 and percentage capital D. We know that percentage small d is used for format specifications for integer value, but percentage capital D cannot be used as a format specifications, so it is used as a string. So output becomes 0, 3 and %3. Next questions. What will be the output of the following statement? Print 3 plus goodbye. Here 3 plus means it can erase first 3 character G00. Then we get the output DBYE. So output becomes DBYE. Okay. Next questions. What will be the output of the following statements? Int I equal to 1, j equal to I --(-2). So what will be the output? Here, given that I equal to 1, we write these statements as j equal to I --(-2), that is I --(-2). We know that --(+). So I --(+2) means 1 + 2 = 3. Here I --(- is used for post decrement, so value of I is decremented but it is never affected, so value becomes 1, that is 1 + 2 = 3. So output becomes 3. Next questions. What will be the output of the following program? Int x, y equal to 10, x equal to x star of null, print a %dx. When we convert null value to integers, it convert as a 0. So we know that what are the value of y. When you multiply with 0, the output becomes 0. So value of x becomes 0. 0 is the output. Next questions. What will be the output of the following statements? Int I equal to 3, print a %d, I comma I plus plus. In this statement, the value of I are operated as from right side, that is from these positions. So it is post increment. So the value of I is print 3. After incrementing the value of I, it again print 4. So I output is become 3, then it's 4, that is 43. So output becomes 43. Next questions. What would be the output of the following program? Char str is an array, string type array, character type array, 65AB. We write it as 65AB and last character should be null. 65AB, last character should be null. So size of the character becomes 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Total output is 5. So output becomes 5. 5 characters. Next questions. What will be the value of A after the following code is executed? Hash depend square x x star x. This is a macro. int a equal to square 2 plus 3. Macro operates similar type of functions. So when we pass the value of 2 plus 3 inside the square, that is x equal to 2 plus 3, we write square x, x star x, that is value of x equal to 2 star 3 into 2 star 3. So we operate as 2 plus 6 plus 3 equal to 11. So output becomes 11. This is the rules of the macro. The value of x written as 2 star 3 into 2 star 3. Okay. Next questions. What will be the output of the following statements? Void function c, int x equal to 0, static int y equal to 0, x plus plus, y plus plus, and two functions are called. We know that the value declared inside the function, that is local functions, that is local variables, and after the end of the function, the value of the variable is ended or terminated. That is, it forget the values. But if you declare the static value, static keyword inside integer value, and value of y is preserved. So here is a, x is a normal integer value and y is a static integer value whose value is stored. So the value of x is initialized to 1 after each function call. Since it is local variables and the value of x are forget after each calls. So output becomes x equal to 1 for 2 times of calling of the functions. And the value of y has been incremented and its value is preserved since it is static variable. So first function call, the value of is y equal to 1. And second function call, the value of y becomes 2. Since it is static variable and value is preserved. Last question. So here is option is 4, 1, 8. These two options. Last questions. The precedence of arithmetic operator from highest to lowest. We know the BODMAS rule. BODMAS, BADMAS, bracket, division, multiplications, addition, subtractions. But there is a C language another option, that is finding the remainder value. So here is the precedence becomes. First percentage, there is remainder, there is multiplication, division, plus, addition, and subtraction. If you like my videos, kindly subscribe and attach with me for technical videos. Thank you very much.